in the healthy condition, these rascals. They do not know anything, still they are passing on as great scientists, philosophers. They do not inquire that I do not want to die. Why death is enforced upon me? There is no such inquiry, neither there is any solution. And still they are scientists. What kind of scientist? Science means that you advance in knowledge so that your miserable condition of life can be reduced, minimized. That is science. Otherwise, what is this science? They are simply promising in future. But what you are delivering just now, sir? Now just now you suffer, as you are suffering, go on suffering. In future we shall find out some chemicals. Now, actually, atyantik dukkha nivritti, atyantik, ultimate. Atyantik means ultimate, dukkha means suffering. That should be the aim of human life. So they do not know what is atyantik dukkha. Dukkha means suffering. The atyantik dukkha is pointed out in the Bhagavad Gita. Here is the atyantik dukkha, sir. What is this? Janma mittu jara vyadhi. Birth, death, old age and disease. So what you have done for vanishing or making or nullifying these dukkha, these sufferings. So there is no such thing in the material world. The atyantik dukkha nivritti, ultimate relinquishment from all kinds of suffering is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. What is that? Mam upito kaunteya. Dukkhalayam asahasatam napnubanti mahatmana saṃsiddhiṃ paramāṅgata. So you should read all this. You have got Bhagavata, everything explanation. This is atyantik dukkha nivritti, ultimate relinquishment from all sufferings. What is that? Mām apeta. One who approaches me, or one who comes to me, back to home, back to God. So they have no knowledge what is God, and whether one can go back to home, back to Godhead, it is a practical thing or not. No knowledge. Simply like animals, that's all. No knowledge. They pray, oh God, give us our daily bread. They are asking, what is God? Can you explain? No. Then whom we are asking in the air? If I ask, if I submit some petition, there must be some person. So I do not know what is that person, where to submit this petition. Simply, they say that is in the sky. The sky, there are so many birds also, but there is not God. So no knowledge. No knowledge, imperfect knowledge, all. And they are passing on scientists, philosophers, great thinkers, writers, all rubbish, all rubbish. The only book is Bhagavad, Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. All rubbish. In the Bhagavad it is said, Sadhbhāga viśarga janatāga viplā jasmin pratiśrūkum avaddhavattabhi nāmāni nantasya jasaṁ kitāni jap sinnanti gāyanti giranti sādhava. And the other side, natat bacas citta padaṁ harer jasa praginita karhichi tad bāyasam tīrtham. Tad bāyasam tīrtham. Any literature which has no connection with the knowledge of God. Tad Vaisham Tirtham, that is just like the place where the crows take enjoyment, where the crows take enjoyment, the filthy place. And the swans, the white swans, they take pleasure in a nice clear water where there is garden, there is birds. So there are, even in the animals, there are divisions, swan class and crow class. Natural division. The crow will not go to the swan will not go to the crow. Similarly, in the human society, there are crow class men and swan class men. The swan class man will come here, because here everything is clear, nice, good philosophy, good food, good education, good dress, good mind, everything good. And crow class man will go to such and such club, such and such party, naked dance, so many things. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is meant for the swan class of men, not for the crow class of men, no. But we can convert the crows into swan. That is our purpose. One who was crow is now swimming like swan. That we can do. That is the benefit of Krishna consciousness. So, when the swans become crow, that is material world. That is Krishna says, jada jada hi dharma saglani bhavati. The living entity is encased in this material body and is trying to gratify the senses, one body after another, one body after another, one body after another. This is the position, and dharma means to gradually turn the crows into swan. That is dharma. Just like one man may be very illiterate, uncultured, but he can be converted into educated, cultured man by education, by training. So that possibility is there in the human form of life. I cannot train a dog to become a devotee. That is difficult. It can be done also. But I may not be so powerful, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did. When he was passing through the jungle, Jharikhanda, the tigers, the snakes, the deers, all the animals, they became devotees. They became devotees. So what was possible for me, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because he is God himself, he can do anything. We cannot do that. But we can work in the human society. It doesn't matter however fallen a man is, if he follows our instruction, then he can be turned. And that is called dharma. Dharma means to bring one to his original position. That is dharma. So there may be degrees. But the original position is that we are part and parcel of God, and when we understand that we are part and parcel of God, that is our real position of life, that is called Brahma-bhuta state. Understanding is Brahma-realization, identification. So Krishna comes, this explanation, just like Kunti says that apare vasudevasya devakam jatito abhagat. Vasudeva and Devaki prayed to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that we want a son like you. That is our desire. Although they were married, they did not beget any child. They engaged themselves in tapasya, severe tapasya. So Krishna came before them, what do you want? Now we want a child like you. Therefore you have to say, Vasudevasya Devakyam, Jachita, Jachita, sir, we want a son like you. Now what, where there is possibility of another God? Krishna is God. God cannot be two. God is one.